It's another beautiful day. Welcome to Sahara TV. My name is Kwesi Baako. Now, many governments the world over come to power with the promise of creating employment and an enabling environment for the youth. In Ghana, the ruling National Democratic Congress made a strong promise in their manifesto dubbed the Better Ghana Agenda. Now, a few weeks ago, President John Mahama appointed youth activist Ras Mubarak to head the National Youth Authority to coordinate the government's policy on investing in the youth. The appointment has excited many, but the opposition New Patriotic Party is, let's just say, not that impressed. Now, we were billed to speak with Ras Mubarak, but he's currently on another assignment and could not make the interview. However, we have a member of the opposition New Patriotic Party, MP for Mpraeso, Seth Acheampong, on the line now from Ghana to share his thoughts on how well the Mahama government is doing with youth employment in Ghana. You're welcome to Sahara TV, Seth Acheampong.
Thank you very much, Kwesi.
Okay.
And good afternoon to your listeners, but good evening in Ghana.
Yes, definitely. And Happy New Year, too.
Many, many happy returns, my brother.
Okay. All right, so let's...
The year will look good for all of us.
Definitely, most definitely. Now, let's start by asking you, on a scale of 1 to 10, how much would you give the Mahama government for youth development and job creation?
In fact, as a realist, I must say that I'm not necessarily an extremist to say that I expect this administration to have a magic wand. But that notwithstanding, I think they could have done better. And if I'm to rate them as you put it to me, I will rate them 3/10, which I think is abysmal. Abysmal in that what they promised, they could not even deliver. I'm being more charitable and generous to offer them a 30%, because ideally they could not meet any of the targets in the first year of administration, and this is a very tall order. If you have a loaded promise and your first year of action, you still, as they put it, in first gear, then it is really a difficulty.
Well, but Seth, this is only the first year, and it's a 4-year term. Would you buy into a suggestion that, you know, the first gear can only get better? It can only move to second, third, and fourth gear. Is that a possibility?
Thank you. Like I said, a realist. I'm not that a pessimist to say that they can't improve. But this is governance, and if you don't cry at them, they may think everybody is comfortable.
Definitely, which I get that point.
As a younger person and who happens to be in the legislature of Ghana, mm-hmm. who happens to live in communities with youth, there is a difficulty because people are getting out of colleges. We don't have expansion of our industries, let alone the existing ones even being improved upon. And so there is that level of frustration.
You mentioned that. Yes, please land on that point, and then I'll go ahead and ask.
What I was going to say is that new initiatives to enhance the running economy, to engage new hands. If the economy, which the structure of the economy is not expanding, that means you're still in the status quo. We're still remaining where we are. Mm. Population keeps increasing. And so we ought to adopt certain policies that will enable the new ones who are coming in get placement, and then those exiting can be comfortably left to leave, allowed to leave. Mm. But here we are, government in compensation arrears in respect of gratuities to overaged staff of government are not unpaid. So they cannot even ask people to go home. How then do you encourage the youth? Because they are ready, but they cannot find jobs.
Yeah, this though has been an ongoing thing. I mean, successive governments have had issues with trying to constructively engage the youth in you know, like nation building and also to create jobs. Wouldn't you say so? I mean, comparing with what your own government faced when they were in power.
Beautiful. My own government, before they left office, at least drafted what we call the Youth Bill. And this bill, this administration, with its predecessor, the President Mills administration, inherited the bill. I remember at the first then parliamentarian in 2009, we had a workshop, went through the entire bill, yet the bill could not be forwarded by the ministry after it had gotten to the agency department for us to work on in parliament. In this year's budget statement, it was reported that it is far advanced. 4 years down the line, far advanced. It has still not seen which found its way into parliament. It tells you that we are losing focus. We are not taking serious the rhetoric. We are not taking serious the words we say when it comes to the youth. And that is our worry. Mind you, population everywhere across the globe, the youth are many and more than adults. And if we wouldn't want, for instance, unfortunately, I may be using an example people wouldn't like, that if we witness what went on in a couple of years back with the Arab Spring, it tells you that the world is at a risk if we do not find the right framework to accommodate our youth. And so it is a matter which is dear to every person. We must sit around the table and think it through. It is not a political subject. It is not a political subject.
It is not.
Matter, it is a matter which hangs on all of our necks. I am going to go to my constituency. I'm on my way there because traditionally tomorrow is Akwesi Daya. I must go and greet our chief. This is the first Akwesi Daya in the year. So I must go and pay homage to the traditional authority. At least I have over 20 youth who have completed schooling and are standing and waiting for me as I get home with their certificates, asking me to go look for jobs for them. So this is the reality of it.
Now this is not new at all, because I mean, if you look at the northern part of the country, for instance, there's been generations of an exodus of people moving down south looking for jobs, which may not necessarily be there. Did your government plan? I know you're not in government now, but I'm asking you if your government's policy, that's your party's policy on the youth, does it have anything to address this dichotomy?
Exactly so. Some of the things that we planned in our manifesto was to ensure that you harness these people and put them together. A lot of them are sleeping in front of shops. Majority who comes to down south, right away from Kumasi to Accra, to Takoradi and its environs, because of what, quote-unquote, we call them locally, apalans, kayaye.
Yeah.
They carry goods around the community that they ply their trade in. And this is not something we must encourage. And we look into ensuring that we offer equal opportunity up north. It is not necessarily people coming from only the northern region. Even people from our own southern sector, rural urban migration. That is the reason why what we call today the Ghana Youth and Employment Program, what was created under my party's administration under President Kufuor, the National Youth Employment Program, which is now being called JIDA, which every day we hear of having new models and its attendant issues. This government set up a probing team. They probed JIDA. So we speak. No action has been taken. We did not initiate it. Government saw that wrong was going in there and decided to look into it by itself. They looked into it. A report came up. The report was reviewed by a technical committee. Another advisors to the president reviewed it before it got to the president. No action so far. And these are things which go to demoralize people, which means we in public office are not living up to the oath that we've sworn.
That's interesting.
That is the deal.
That's interesting. And I also want to pick your thoughts on SADC, because the government, President Mahama's government, came to power with a promise of a Savannah Development Authority, which was supposed to take care of the you know, gap, the yawning gap between the North and the South in terms of development. What's your own thoughts on SADC? How do you think it's performing?
Kwesi, SADC is a beautiful scheme. We are equally going to set up a Northern Development Fund or authority, same. We're going to do a similar thing, okay? But hey, we want to develop the North, set up an authority for the North. Must we come and put up an ultra-modern edifice in Accra, the South, to manage the North? Must we do that? Must we do a SADC secretariat in Accra? Can't we erect those structures up there?
But Accra is the capital of the country.
Yes. No, Kwesi. Kwesi is an authority. Accra is the capital of the country. I agree with that. Must we spend a greater chunk of the money we want to give to the people on the ground to build up the economical status, out of which we, as a country, by our own taxation system, can generate revenue from their earnings after we have invested in them? We don't have our priorities right. And that is what we keep on telling government. We don't have our priorities.
So
right.
I take it you are not very enthused about SADC.
At all.
Okay.
At all.
All right.
Attendant issues. You heard in the media, once you're a media person, you heard about the recent issues of the joint partnership between government and private people, which they had reported. They had groomed some birds, and which were non-existent. The void quantity they were calling were not the right quantities. These are genuine concerns that we have to be responsible living with as a people in this country.
Okay.
And sometimes when they come across like that, and they are not attended upon with the zeal and the seriousness that is expected of men in office, then we are all in shame.
Okay.
I'm ashamed because our colleagues in executive are not living up to the mandate.
Okay, this is really the point where I would have wished Ras Mubarak or someone from the ruling party was here, because I really want we don't want to just talk. We want to
get different
parts of the argument and get to the crux of the matter. But let's
It's unfortunate.
Yeah, let's move on though. It's not uncommon to hear allegations of corruption. People would say stuff like agencies like the National Youth Authority are just a conduit for the government to siphon money or to kind of like channel money to their party faithful and stuff like that. Is that how you feel about the NYA, the National Youth Authority, which Ras Mubarak has just been asked to head, and about other programs like SADC and JIDA and all of that?
I'm not that kind of a character that would just go and pinpoint wrong when there is none. I mean, when I don't see a red herring, I don't call for one.
Mm.
But the truth is that, are we getting our acts right? We just look at what has happened, and you just oppose it. We just passed a budget in Parliament in the last month of December in Parliament, and you just oppose the current year's budget to the past year's budget and look at the performance. Releases. Government could not even go beyond 50% of releases as of the end of third quarter. And it tells you that then we are having serious challenges, because government is the biggest spender in this economy. I will not come and sit here and say that government is using the youth authority as a conduit to definitely, while your party is in office, is your party following who will be appointed into office? However, it doesn't matter if your party people are in office and they cannot do a dime, you still not win, you still not do well. But if they are in office and they are working well, the people will see it. I wouldn't be the person to come and stand here and tout them wrongdoing. Mm. However, their actions depict it.
Okay. Now, your party proposed a National Youth Development Authority in its 2012 manifesto. Is that close to what we're seeing with the NYA now? And what I'm asking is, what's your party's policy on the youth and youth employment?
We had a fantastic idea when, at the time, the National Youth Employment Program, which was a program, was created. It was supposed to be an exit plan. It wasn't a permanent office. Mind you, when we came into office, we did a survey of youth unemployed. And these are empirical approaches to building up good policies into the future. If you do not have data, we unfortunately, I must say this is an international platform, but I must say this, that we're a talent when it comes to data in our country. We're still a developing country. And so it makes planning a challenge. And so to be able to go forward when you have such difficulties, it is to begin to build up that database. And so we commenced with that. We even chastised that. We said, well, putting people together, I want to give them jobs overnight. That was not it. I would say that Rome wasn't built in a day. And so we needed to go through such phases. Then we got a program up, and then we started working with a program. Beautiful. However, unfortunately, we lost out, and we went out. This administration took over and then maintained the same module, rather changed the name of the program into JIDA. That's good. Said they had added on. At the end of the day, the waste that this has caused this country is unprecedented. The waste alone is unprecedented. And so how do we do this? And mind you, we are in competition. And we will not just stand up and criticize and put all our cards on the table. We also must have what we want to do for the people to be able to do a good comparison tomorrow.
Okay.
And if you ask us, what will I do to salvage the situation? Many a time, and I said this on the House floor this last year when I was making my submission in Parliament in respect to the budget, I said, I now notice that most of the criticisms that we give to government, it has found space in this year's budget statement, because they are trying to correct themselves now. So the things we speak about, alternatives that we bring, they are beginning to work with them.
Well, are you giving the NDC government props for that? If they are listening to you, that must be a good thing, because that's a job. You have to keep them on their toes, and they seem to be listening to you. That's a good thing,
exactly.
Right?
Exactly. That's what I said. That was a commendation from me to them. That I've seen a couple of things that we have criticized government on, which have found space in
the budget. Okay, now we have a very few minutes left, but I still want to touch on one or two more questions that I have for you. You mentioned earlier that the NDC government has not lived up to its billing. It has not lived up to the promises that it made in their manifesto. Can you give examples of some of these? Just one or two.
Beautiful. You're talking about it. I won't go too far. I'll just go talk about education. The government promised that it was going to, because it is youth and it is education, you have majority of the youth in education. The government promised it was going to build a minimum of 50 senior high school buildings. Happened from last year. They could not even put up five to be on a charitable side.
It's only the first year.
You see, it is the first year. Did we take salary for the first year, or did we not take salary for the first year?
Well, we did, but we did not take salary for all the 4 years. We only took for the first year.
The program says that we are going to do 200 schools in 4 years.
Yes, so I would expect that you judge them on that
so
after
I would
4 years.
That at least, because see, if you said 200, so you do 50 per year, I would have expected if they had done 10. I'd have clapped for them that, yes, it is the 30. You couldn't reach 50. Now you did 10. You could not even do 5.
Did they start, though? Did they get off the ground at all?
It was in the last quarter they started running around, scouting for space, scouting for grounds to break to commence.
Well, we'll probably see the rest of them in the election year. The last question I want to ask you, Seth, is that
must we run our country this way?
No. I mean, that's
only election years.
No, I mean that was just an off the cuff statement.
I agree with you that that has been a character. But must we continue doing things the same old way?
Definitely not. Now your party is going to Congress very soon. Your presidential candidate in the last election, Nana Akufo-Addo, hasn't said so himself, but a lot of people are rooting for him to still run in the next election. But we also have people like Alan Chamartin and a few others on the fringes. Can you share with us at all, is it likely that Nana Akufo-Addo is going to stand again on your ticket for the next elections?
As a matter of fact, I have no sign, I have no clear sign as to whether Nana will stand or not, not necessarily even with Alan Chamartin. The good thing is that we're now doing our homework, building our internal party structure. We just completed with our polling station elections. We're going to run our regional elections pretty soon in a couple of weeks. And then by end of March, we will run our national offices elections. Post that, then a timetable will be scheduled as to when we may do our presidential primaries. However, as a practical and pragmatic politician, I know people may come, but as to who is coming immediately, I have no idea.
Okay. Who would you be comfortable with, though, if I can push you to the wall? Do you think you should still feel the old guard, or you think it's time for fresh blood?
Crazy, pushing me, you know my parties are bound with talent. Everybody who is put in the saddle will rally around them and make sure we get Ghana running better. Every person is good. The reason is that my party is abound with talent. You know it. I mean, name it.
I also realize that there's a lot of young talent sitting on the benches whilst the old guard continues to run things. So I don't know if that's going to change anytime soon. But yeah, you were right. NPP is
it's about the talent. Who
it
knows?
Is,
maybe
totally.
They even decide that they want to promote a young person. We don't know. We are not there yet.
We might see you as the flag bearer for the next elections. Who knows? Thank you very much, Seth. And like I said to you, we are interested in partnering with you on, you know, in your coming primaries. We definitely want to be part of that journey. So listeners, viewers, keep it on this dial. We'll definitely be here as we partner the New Patriotic Party in Ghana in their primaries and all the way to the next elections. Thank you very much, Seth Acheampong.
Okay, Kwesi. I wish you and your listeners a pleasant day.
Yes.
Thanks so much for the opportunity.
You too. Thank you very much. Happy New Year again. Keep it here, viewers. We'll be right back with more.